Hi, welcome back to the Arcade Repair Tips video series. We're doing a cap kit right now on this monitor chassis, and we've already found a couple of bad caps. How do we know they were bad?
Well, we checked them with an ESR meter from Matt Electronics.
MattElectronics.com. This was about $50, so it's not a real high dollar tool. There are better ones.
This one will do the job just fine. You can check in circuit, which comes in very handy. It's a lot faster. Like you said, we found two caps that were bad, and from the heat, what they do is they dry up and they'll change value and go back.
All right, so we took the old caps, we desoldered them, used some desoldering braid, and we pulled the old caps out. We tested them in circuit, then we took them out and also tested them out of circuit. And these guys are bad, so we're ready to put in. Now, there's some numbers and letters and stuff on here. What do those mean?
Well, when you're replacing a cap, the first number is usually the voltage. It could be backwards. You'll have a V after the number. That's your voltage. You always want to replace with the same voltage. You can go up in voltage, but you can never go down in voltage. The next number is going to have a UF, and that's going to be your microfarad, and that needs to be exact whatever come out. You can't substitute anything.
So what came out of here says 10 UF, so that's 10 microfarads at 100 volts. What do you have?
I have a 10 microfarad at 160 volts.
Okay. They have to be 10 microfarads.
Correct.
But it's okay that we went up in voltage.
That's correct. You can always go up, never go down.
Okay. So why... I'm looking at this, and one of the legs is longer than the other one. Why is that?
Well, there's polarity on these. There's a negative and a positive. And on your board, they'll either have a plus for positive, or a lot of times I'll have a black mark for a negative. You need to make sure you have that correct.
And there are a couple arcade boards that come from overseas and different places that do not have it on there. So by all means, keep in mind which way the negative side, and you can tell the negative side on a cap because it'll have a stripe on the side. So remember which way the stripe was when you pull it out. So when you put it back in, and sometimes you can't read on the back of the board, you had so many repairs or kind of been scraped off. So keep in mind which way it goes, because it matters, right?
It matters greatly.
If I replaced 50 caps on a monitor chassis and put one on backwards,
you're going to do more damage than what you had before you started.
So. Exactly. So take your time. Make sure you know which way is polarity. And I'm sure there's going to be more in the article about this. So please read that part very carefully and take your time. Don't rush. Okay, so now we're ready to put it in. And let's see, on the board here, it has a plus towards me. So that is going to be the shorter end, right? The longer end.
The longer
end. Okay, I want to make sure.
The black stripe away from you.
The black stripe is away from me. So we're just going to stick it through the holes here. Okay. Now what?
When you stick it through the holes, you'll have the leads. Just pull them up a little bit and bend them out. That will give tension and give you time to solder without your cap falling back off the board.
Right. So even if you're by yourself, you do this all the time. Without any help, you're by yourself. Just bend the legs a little so it will stay in place, right?
Correct.
Okay. Well, Michael, you want to do the honors?
Okay.
There's our solder and our soldering iron.
On these older boards, because of the heat from the board itself, the traces get real brittle, and you need to make sure you don't let your heat stay on there for a long period of time, or it will peel the thin copper trace off the board. But you want to make sure you get enough heat so you don't have a cold solder joint also. Just place your iron there and use your solder. And that's all it's took.
That fast, huh?
Then you take a pair of snippers and always make sure you cut your leads off. You don't want them touching metal or grounding out to the rest of the board. Just snip them even with the solder connection and you're done.
So we have now replaced one cap, and your cap kit may come with 10 or 11, but you just keep doing the same thing over and over, right?
Correct. And like Tim said, just make sure you keep your polarities right. That'll cause you major problems.
Right. You can ruin a whole cap job by one cap. So take your time. And if you don't feel comfortable, by all means, email us, send it in to us for repair. We have reasonable rates. But thank you guys for watching, and stay tuned for more videos.